Thanks for tuning in. Today we're going to be reviewing the Magicshine Monteer 8000S bike light. So one common question we often get with bike lights is, how many lumens do I need? The answer to that depends on where you ride and how the light is designed. However, today that answer is going to be 8000 with the new Monteer 8000S bike light. This puts out a ridiculous 8000 lumens and is part of their new Monteer lineup, which includes updated batteries and updated lenses. Packaging wise, really nicely done. You can see you have the black and orange color scheme that's characteristic of Magicshine. You have the nice glossy sticker of the actual light and this really hefty, nice cardboard box. Let's go ahead and open that up, and while I do that, we'll go over the specs. So this is the top of the line version of the Monteer lineup, and that comes in at $399. It has a Garmin style mount, which is something Magicshine's been doing a lot lately, and it's a really nice way to share the light on multiple mounts. It has a 5-LED design to achieve that amazing 8,000 lumen output. It has an aluminum out in front mount included, which is a nice perk. Full aluminum housing, as well as the large MJ-6118 battery pack. This is their largest battery pack, 7.2 amps. And it's 10,000 milliamp output, so very beefy. Now, in terms of what comes in the box, we get the head unit itself, which is surprisingly small. You would think it'd be a lot larger for the 8,000 lumens. What isn't small is the battery pack. This thing's quite large. You get two straps to mount that onto your frame. You get the out and front mount. This is not the Magicshine TTA. It's a stubbier version, but aluminum. Single-sided, but it looks like you could put something on the backside if you had the bolts and puck. You get multiple spacers to accommodate different handlebars. You get the plug wire, and this is pretty cool. So the battery pack has a detachable plug that clips in. And this is the round black style plug, not the orange plug you've seen in some of the newer Magicshine lights. Get a USB-C to USB Type-A connector to charge the battery pack. And a little Allen key here to install the out and front mount, as well as a little manual. Now let's take a look at the weight of this bike light setup. First, we'll start with the battery pack, which is gonna be the heaviest portion of this. We have the two straps, as well as the plug, which you need to connect it to the light. That all comes in at 422 grams. So pretty hefty, but a lot of output, and that's why the light is able to have such amazing run times. The out and front mount, which is a nice aluminum construction, comes in at 34 grams. While the headlamp itself comes in at 144 grams. Now let's take a look at the fit and finish of the Monteer 8000S. Now, if this light looks familiar to you, it's because it shares the same housing as the existing Monteer 6500. With the new Monteer lineup, they've updated the LEDs, as well as the battery pack to put out more power. This is the top dog, this is the 8000S. They also have a new 6500S, as well as lower models such as the 3500. Now, what's really surprising about these lights is that they're so tiny, especially with the wired setup. The headlamp itself, you can see, fits in the palm of my hand, and it's fairly lightweight given the 5-LED design. This is because they're able to offload all the battery management stuff to the battery pack itself, and then just worry about thermal heat management and heat sinks with the headlamp itself. This also means you can mount this on your helmet pretty easily, as it's fairly light and you can just run the wire down. So jumping right into it, let's go over the new lens design. So it's a 5-LED design, and as with the previous Monteer, you can run this in two different modes. The top row, which is the flood lamps, and then the bottom two, which are two flood LEDs. This is a little bit counterintuitive, as you can see the bottom two LEDs have this dimple design that makes the beam a little more diffuse. However, that's because the top lights, LEDs have a 32 degree beam spread, so you get that more flood effect, while the bottom two are 21 degrees. Now you can run this with the bottom two or the top three or all together in the hybrid mode. The LED models here have been updated as well. The top uses three Cree XHP 50.2s, while the bottom two are XM L2 models. Now, as a mountain bike, mountain biking light is really designed to throw a lot of light with a really nice spread beam. So you're not going to see any diffusers here or any beam cutoff. So if you run this on the road, there's a ton of glare on here. Now the housing, although it looks familiar, it's really nicely made. So it's aluminum design. You have little fins here for heat dissipation. It's a nice IPX5 rating as well, so nice waterproofing. You have the lens itself recessed slightly behind the housing, so there are no side cutouts here, unlike a lot of commuter lights, which would have a side cutout for better side visibility. Pretty simple design, so very compact. The fins extend all the way down, and the best feature, obviously, is the Garmin mount. This lets you use any standard out-in-front mount without having to use proprietary mounts from different manufacturers, something that Magicshine has really done with all their new lights and something I hope other manufacturers will pick up as well. Now, the interface on this is also carried over from the previous Monteer 6500. A single button interface. It's also illuminated, so this will go from green, red to blinking red. And that'll let you know if the battery is between 21 to 100%, 6 to 20, or 0 to 5. Now the interface is a little bit clunky. It's a single click to turn it on, double click to switch between top and bottom, and then a long hold to turn it off with a single click inside a mode to cycle through them. And we'll go over that later with the light output. Now the battery pack is another really cool feature here. This is the largest and most powerful Magicshine has offered to date. It's still the same model numbers, but it's been updated to use 21700 lithium ion cells. So that means there's four batteries in here, and that combined gives you a 10,000 milliamp capacity, so really large. And with the new cells, it's very compact. Really nice build quality here. And you can see it also has USB Type-C charging, another really nice feature. So if I pop off the top, you can see you have a nice rubber gasket and then USB Type-C on top, as well as a little battery check thing here. So this is nice, you can actually see another three level, or perhaps four level, to tell you what the battery's at. You can also use this as a power bank. And that's the nice feature, as you can detach the bike connector portion. So the bottom of this, if I pull off the little rubber cover, this is a nice snap-on. This is what to attach to the bike headlight, but if you're not using this as a bike light, you can simply unclip this, put the dust cover back on, and then use this as a power bank to charge your other devices. There are three basic modes of operation: spot, flood, or hybrid, where spot is the bottom two LEDs, flood is the top three, and hybrid is all of them. It's not very obvious, especially when you put them side by side. Spot is a little bit more focused than flood, but when you're riding, it's very hard to distinguish. There are also 15 different output modes for this light. So you have four different intensities for each of the modes. You have eco, low, medium, high, as well as a flash mode. So you have quite a few options that can really tailor to the ride. The beam quality is really excellent on this. It's very wide, no hot spots, good distribution, and really far throw. So whether you're doing downhill racing or just commuting on the street, this has more than enough light to keep up with you. The other thing that's great about such a powerful light is that even the low settings put out more light than most commuter lights, and they still provide you over 10 hours of runtime. So it's something you can run at low settings for a really long time. So a lot of functionality here. We're most impressed with the full hybrid mode, which throws a lot of light. You have good side distribution and really far throw. The full 8,000 lumen is also really crazy. It really lights up the road and it's overkill for most purposes. The flash mode here also is quite disturbing, especially at 2,400 lumens. Now when you're riding, again, it's pretty hard to distinguish what mode you're in, and as you can see, the flash mode is very distracting and can mess with your depth perception. Otherwise, it's pretty simple to cycle through the modes. We found low and even eco were sufficient, while the higher settings were almost too bright for most riding. But the 8,000 lumen is quite impressive, as you can see here. It really lights up everything and is really impressive. It's quite fun to ride at night, especially with something like the 8000S attached to your handlebar. Otherwise, it's really easy to switch between modes and provides more enough distribution to really see things to your side and ahead of you. So now let's do a little comparison between the Monteer and some other bike lights on the market. As you can see here, I have many of the Magicshine variations, the MJ908, the 906, the Eagle F3, as well as the associated battery packs to show a comparison, as well as some of the commuter lights like the Alti 2000 and the Phoenix BC21R V2. Now, right off the bat, I have both Monteer's 8000S and the 6500S. You can see they're the same, so same housing. Essentially, they just change the output on these. With these, you get the same battery packs as well, while the lower Monteer variation use a smaller battery pack. So they're simply programmed to put out more power, further beam, and maybe a little lens modification as well. So right off the bat, comparing these to your standard commuter light, you can see commuter lights with the batteries actually integrated within the headlamp, you end up with a larger headlamp compared to the Monteer. It's almost half the size, as you just have the heatsink and the LEDs. So that's one big advantage of this. And you can get a lot more output, while these are usually limited to under 2000. Here's the Alti 2000. You get the OLED screen, which is something I wish the Monteers had. But again, a lot bigger, same Garmin mount, but you can see just a lot larger form factor. But obviously, all-in-one design means you don't have to lug around a big battery. Now, comparing this to some of other Magicshine's mountain biking lights, this is actually my favorite, the Eagle F3. Four LED design, same idea though. You have the flood and then the spotlights. You can see similar form factor. The F3 is actually bigger. They have a two-button interface and a more obvious battery indicator. So that's a nice plus of this. And a bigger heatsink design. It's actually surprising that the Monteers have such a small form factor, as you would think the heat would actually require larger fins, but actually they work pretty well despite the smaller size. So you can see they've really improved the build quality as well, where this is all plastic. This is full aluminum and really clean. Now some of their newer MJ lights, this is the 906. So you get the 5 LED design. This puts out, I think, about 3200 lumen. You can see smaller form factor, but a little bit taller, and again, more plasticky, and it uses their old rubber style mounts. I think the newer ones actually have switched to Garmin, which is a better design. Now, if an 8000 lumen Monteer light sounds familiar, it's because they actually have an 8000 lumen MJ908. This was a theoretical 8000 lumens though, so you don't actually get that. But much larger form factor, you can see almost double the size. It's all heat fins, which is something, again, I'm surprised not to see here. And larger overall, taller, wider. You do get the LED screen, which is really nice. So you can see which mode you're in with the Monteers. You don't really know what mode you're in without peeking over. But definitely nice to see more output, more real measured output versus theoretical in a smaller form factor. The other thing I really like about the updated Monteer lights, especially with the 6500S and the 8000S, is the battery packs have improved. Previously, they used the 18650 lithium ion battery packs. This had 6 batteries in here. So you can see 3 here, 3 here. It's heavier, chunkier. They also had an even larger one. This is the MJ6090. So you can see really large. It essentially takes up your whole water bottle cage, but it had a nice removable mount here. But very heavy. It has more capacity than the other battery packs we're looking at now. It has 10.4 versus the 10,000 that we see with the Monteers, but you can see quite a bit bigger. Put these side by side, you can see they've really slimmed it down. Made it easier to carry, and with the removable plug, you can see how it's non-removable. That's what I really like about the new Monteer battery pack. You can simply pop this out, put the dust cap on, and then just stick this in your pocket, carry a spare one if you're on the road, or use this as a power bank. Now let's go over the pros and cons for the Monteer 8000S. What we like about the light is that it's ridiculously bright. It's honestly overkill, but it's awesome to have such a bright light, especially at this price point. It's really hard to find another $400 light with 8000 lumens. It's also really nice to see the USB Type-C charging for the battery pack, which lets you use it as a power bank when you're not riding. Overall, the build quality is also excellent with durable wiring connections, which is often a weak point for a wired battery pack setup. Some of the cons for the light is the fact that it lacks DRLs. That would have been a nice feature for daytime riding. Also, it's very annoying to have to cycle through the flash modes, and nobody really needs three different flash modes for this light. It can be quite jarring, especially if you're going through corners, so you have to be prepared when you're riding to cycle out of it really quickly. Also, it lacks a remote for helmet mounting, which means it's not very practical to mount this on your helmet, even though the lamp head is quite light. Hopefully the next generation will have that feature though. Taking that in everything into account, we'd give the light a 8.9 out of 10. In a lot of ways, this is the muscle car of bike lights. It's just a lot of power and low tech. You don't get any Bluetooth connectivity or cell phone apps. It's very simple, very honest setup. And even though it is overkill, nobody needs 8,000 lumens. It's really fun to ride with this light. So if you're looking for something with really high output, this is a great option. Thanks for watching this review. Don't forget to like and subscribe. You can see more content from us on our website at thesweetcyclist.com, as well as follow us on Instagram at thesweetcyclist. This is The Sweet Cyclist reminding you to enjoy the ride.